In this video, I'll talk about the effects of pressure on solubility and then use Henry's law to determine how much nitrogen gas can be dissolved in a human's bloodstream at different pressures. So we start out being told that at sea level, the partial pressure of nitrogen gas, N2, is 0.80 atmospheres. The solubility of N2 in blood at 37 degrees Celsius and at sea level is 5.6 times 10 to the negative 4th moles per liter. Just real quick, 37 degrees Celsius, that's a human body temperature. A scuba diver at about 130 foot depth breathes air with a partial pressure of N2 equal to 4.0 atmospheres. As you go deeper in the water, you have more pressure, and that's why you have the pressurized air tanks that the scuba divers always carry on their backs. If the diver has a volume of 5.0 liters of blood in his body, calculate how much nitrogen gas is released as he returns to the water's surface. So, Henry's law. This is actually not that difficult of a problem. We're just going to apply Henry's law, and that's this. The concentration C equals some constant times the partial pressure P. So I'm just going to plug that right in there. The concentration C that's told to us, 5.6 times 10 to the negative 4th, and that is moles per liter, equals some constant, and this is what we are going to find, times the partial pressure, and we're told that it is 0.8 at the surface, so 0.80 atmospheres. Solving for that then, Henry's law constant under these circumstances equals 7 times 10 to the negative 4th, or 7.0 times 10 to the negative 4th. The units is moles per liter times atmospheres, where atmospheres is also in the denominator. Okay, we have the constant. The next step then is to take that constant and find the concentration at this partial pressure. So we are going to use the K that we have to find C, the concentration at this new pressure. So C equals 7.0, that's our K, 7.0 times 10 to the negative 4th times our partial pressure, and that is 4 atmospheres, 4.0 to keep our significant digits. And we end up with a concentration of 0.0028 moles per liter. All right, that's at the depth, I'll say. Very deep. So if we have that kind of concentration, let's talk about how many moles we have at that depth. So the number of moles would be this number, 0.0028 moles per liter, multiplied by the number of liters of blood, and that is 5.0 liters. Gives us a total number of moles in the blood of 0.014 moles of N2. That's at depth. That's at depth. So the question is, when we go back up to surface, how much will we still have, will the diver still have dissolved in his bloodstream? And this is why divers have to ascend very slowly, because if they don't, they have all this nitrogen and the bubbles get bigger, and that's called the bends, and it hurts really bad and could get them sick or even kill them. So this is why divers ascend very slowly, so that the nitrogen gas can come out of their bloodstream, can come out of their system gradually. By the time this diver reaches the surface, though, we have a concentration of 5.6 times 10 to the 4th moles per liter. So 5.6 times 10 to the negative 4th moles per liter, and we still have the 5 liters of blood. So multiplied by 5, and we get at the surface 0.0028 moles of N2 dissolved at the surface. So the question is, how much gas is released? So what is the difference between 0.014 and 0.0028? Let's jump to that answer. That is 0.014 minus 0.0028. And just so that we can hang on to more significant digits, we'll just round, I guess. 0.011 moles of N2 released. Now, here's the catch. You think, oh, that's pretty small. That amounts to about 280 milliliters of nitrogen gas. So if the diver went up right away, you've got almost two-thirds of a soda can full of nitrogen gas in this diver system. And that's way too much. That's going to cause a lot of problems. So the diver, again, has to ascend very slowly so that this nitrogen gas doesn't cause problems and so that it can precipitate, that is, come out of his system. I hope that was helpful. If you did think it was helpful, then consider liking this video or sharing it with a friend.